We're going to tell you about the best new blue cards out of Core 2021 you should be on the lookout for. Stay tuned to learn all about it. Welcome to this video. It is part of a video series in collaboration with the Oathbreaker Thoughtcast. In this episode, we'll be looking at the 10 best new blue cards for your Oathbreaker decks out of the Magic Core Set 2021. I make Magic the Gathering and Oathbreaker content, and if that's what you're into, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel, and please also visit Alex Ender's page, the Oathbreaker Thoughtcast. I will be paraphrasing Alex Ender's article. If you want to read the full article, I will put a link down in the description below. As you all know, another MTG preview season has come and gone. This top 10s are based on 1. How strong the card may affect Oathbreaker, and 2. How many different types of Oathbreaker decks we expect the card to see play in. While I do try my best to be as objective as I can, these are ultimately just my thoughts and opinions. With all that out of the way, let's kick things off with my top 10 blue cards from Core 2021 for Oathbreaker. Number 10, Discontinuity. It looks like Time Stop has gotten a bit of an upgrade. End the turn? Effects like this are pretty rare in Magic the Gathering, but they do have their uses. Sundial of the Infinite is one of the better known cards with this type of an ability, and is often paired with the likes of Feldon of the Third Path and Cedrus the Traitor King in the world of EDH. The fact that this spell only costs 2 mana to cast on your turn, the first time around, opens up some interesting possibilities, and although I'm not 100% sure what to expect from this card in Oathbreaker, I'm looking forward to see what players brew up with this spicy new signature spell. A good place for a card like this is decks that are looking to flood the board with token creatures that are going to die at the end of turn, i.e. like a Splinter Twin combo deck. Or, it would also be good in decks where you're using cards that clearly state that at the end of turn you lose the game if you don't fulfill something. That way you can just play this card and your turn and skip over that trigger entirely. This card has some very interesting possibilities. Number 9. Pursued Whale. This big blue 7 drop is, oddly enough, somewhat reminiscent of Goblin Spymaster. The kind of effect stapled to Pursued Whale's Enter the Battlefield trigger is perfect for multiplayer format like Oathbreaker, and the sheer size of this creature will disincentivize most of our opponents from swinging their creatures our way. The only two factors keeping Pursued Whale low on this list are 1. It costs a whopping 7 mana, and 2. It only creates the tokens upon entering the battlefield, as opposed to Goblin Spymaster's repeating trigger. Once these pirate tokens die in combat, your opponents will no longer be forced into attacking one another. We can blink creatures, such as with Venzer, the Sojourner. We will be able to mitigate this downside. And I'm curious to see what other types of strategies find room for this big blue fella. I would also like to point out that this Mobius Dick protects itself with a taxing effect that puts the unlucky opponent that deals with this critter behind. Number 8. Shipwreck Dowser. Speaking of blink value in blue, Shipwreck Dowser is blue's newest source of spell recursion. Similar to Archaeomancer and Mnemonic Wall, the most notable difference between this newcomer and the older versions of it is the fact that Shipwreck Dowser comes into play with prowess, giving it a potential to swing for a lot of damage. Shipwreck Dowser pairs very well with spells like Ghostly Flicker, Eerie Interlude, and Living Death. I'm certain this fish friend will find their own niche in Oathbreaker. This creature certainly has some combo possibilities in my opinion, and a new home in my Kashmina the Enigmatic Mentor Wizard combo deck. Number 7. Miscast. This 1 mana instant is an interesting new counterspell option that could function very well in Oathbreaker. Since every deck in the format has a signature spell, there will always be some number of relevant targets for Miscast. I am unsure where exactly I'd rank this card in comparison to Spell Pierce, and I personally still prefer to run hard counters like fierce guardianship and negate whenever possible. However, Miscast does seem to be a very well-positioned counterspell in Oathbreaker, and I look forward to testing it out in future brews. Number 6. Baron Talarian Archmage. Core 2021 seems to have more Planeswalker interaction than the typical Magic the Gathering set, and this Baron is a perfect example. This 3-drop is functionally a Man of War that can also hit Planeswalkers, making it an excellent new option for Blink strategies. Even removing an opponent's Oathbreaker from the field for only one turn can make a huge difference in some games, especially when it comes to Oathbreaker static abilities. Interestingly enough, this card's second ability seems to encourage building a deck around bouncing your own permanents back to your hand, as opposed to simply just blinking them. Regardless of what specific ways players plan to take advantage of Baron's abilities, I'm excited to see what Oathbreaker decks I can fit this new and improved Man of War into. I am so happy to see Baron back in print, and I remember him fondly from the Magic the Gathering books of my early days. Number 5. Waker of Waves. At first glance, it may seem odd to put a 7-drop, uncommon, this high on the list. However, in my mind, this card isn't really a 7-drop whale. I see this card as a 2-mana instant speed cantrip effect that can coincidentally be played as a huge creature late in the game. Waker of Waves is no plain old cantrip effect either. The fact that it digs you 2 cards deeper into your deck and mills 1 of those cards in the process is deceivingly strong upside, especially when utilizing a self-mill strategy. I don't necessarily think this card will be making any particular big waves in Oathbreaker, but it is a very solid new cantrip option that I am sure plenty of players will be eager to try out. Looking at this card, all I could think was, do Jace Wielder of Mysteries, Labman, and Thassa's Oracles decks really need any more help? Not that I can say anything. This ability is why he's in my 4th of July cycling deck. Number 4. Ghostly Pilferer. If I didn't know better, I'd say this card was designed with Oathbreaker specifically in mind. Ghostly Pilferer's second triggered ability is perfect for a format that uses spells in the command zone, and its activated ability makes it an excellent way to pressure any opponent's planeswalkers. The fact that the last ability is repeatable, a free discard outlet, is notable, and this card's 2 triggered abilities will provide you with extra fuel. Since Ghostly Pilferer is only a 2-1, you'll probably have to buff it up a little bit before it can become a real threat, but that isn't the most difficult hoop to jump through. Overall, I think Ghostly Pilferer is strong, yet fair, new creature that will find a home in various Oathbreaker deck strategies. When I took a look at this card, I felt like someone in R&D was like, what if we made Key to the City a creature? And this baby was born. Number 3. Stormwing Entity. I'm admittedly not the most competitively minded Magic the Gathering player out there, but this card seems really pushed. When utilized in the right deck, Stormwing Entity will functionally be a 2-mana 3-3 with flying and prowess. Oh, and it gives us a little bit of immediate value when entering the battlefield. Because why not? Not every blue deck is going to be able to constantly reduce this card's cost, even in a format with signature spells, but the decks that can will greatly benefit from running this low-cost flyer. Spellslinger and prowess-based decks are the most obvious home for this type of a card, but I wouldn't even mind trying this card out in a Saheeli Sublime Artificer Thoughtcast list. Regardless of what particular decks choose to play this card, Stormwing Entity is a creature I look forward to running and dread having to play against. Number 2. See the Truth. See the Truth has probably been one of the most heavily discussed cards from Core 2021 in the Oathbreaker community. I've even seen some players imply that this card may be ban-worthy, namely due to the potential potency as a signature spell. Although See the Truth is certainly strong, I, personally, would say it is far from ban-worthy due to Commander Tax. A 2-mana sorcery that draws 3 cards is powerful. A 4-mana sorcery that draws 3 cards is solid. But it's still just a harmonize. A 6 mana sorcery that draws 3 cards is borderline unplayable. See the Truth does have the upside of not being restricted to any particular archetype as opposed to a signature spell like Thoughtcast. Even still, I feel pretty confident that See the Truth will prove to be a strong but fair addition to Blue's roster of signature spells. I disagree on this one, but maybe that's because I have been coming up with all sorts of ways to abuse this beauty since the minute it was spoiled, and I can't contain my excitement and exuberance at seeing how people will use this card in their decks. Number 1. Teferi, Master of Time. Oh my goodness, they finally did it. The static ability on this newest iteration of Teferi gets around some of the largest restrictions on Planeswalkers as a card type. And it does so in a way that becomes even more powerful in a multiplayer format like Oathbreaker. In a 4-player game, this Planeswalker can potentially net 4 loyalty in one turn cycle, all while giving its owner a significant amount of card filtering. This huge potential uptick in loyalty also means that Teferi can reach ultimate status pretty quickly when left unchecked, even if only for a few rounds of the table. I can't say for sure whether or not Teferi, Master of Time is powerful enough to be banned, but I definitely think it is a riskier card in that sense than See the Truth. In hopes that Teferi's inability to literally win the game on his own will be enough to prevent him from taking over too many tables, but in any case, I'm sure Teferi, Master of Time, is going to be a very powerful new addition to Blue's roster of Planeswalkers in Oathbreaker. I for one hope that he does see the Banhammer, since many games will go, I take a turn, I play my delayed win con. I take my second turn and win during my upkeep. This is not a fun play pattern, as this is not interactive and your win con doesn't need to survive a round of play against your opponents, but that's just my opinion. Having said all that, what's your favorite blue card from Core 2021, and are there any blue cards you're particularly excited about trying out in Oathbreaker? Make sure to tell us in the comments or on Twitter. Stay tuned for our next episode, which will be the top 10 black cards from Core 2021 for Oathbreaker. And please check out the Deck Tech playlist here and a YouTube suggested video here. And thanks again, and I hope you had fun with me and the Oathbreaker Thoughtcast.